Dear students, let us start the discussion on today's newspaper, that is the 27th September 2016. The first article is related to the simultaneous polls to the legislative assemblies and the Lok Sabha. What are the advantages and disadvantages? We can broadly classify them as, one is the governance onto the advantage side. The repetitive operation of the model code of conduct is inhibiting the government from announcement of new programs and projects. And added to that, the governments are forced to resort to the populistic measures to win over the elections. So in this context, there is a clear obstruction to the functioning of the various governance institutions in the country. And the ministers, including the prime minister, has to spend their valuable time on campaigning for the political parties. And the second thing is expenses. The elections, they are going to cause a huge expense to the election commission and also to the government, various political parties. So in this context, India has a regular season of the elections. If you compare in this year itself, there are four seasons of the elections which have happened. Now on to the other side. So why the simultaneous elections need not be conducted? India is essentially a diverse nation, and elections have to reflect this diversity. So the political diversity flows from the social diversity in India, and elections have to represent the same. So in this context, if a model code of conduct is becoming an inhibition, model code of conduct can be amended rather than bringing the simultaneous elections into the country. And the second thing is, the simultaneous elections are a possibility, but however, the voting behavior of the citizens gets influenced because of simultaneous elections. From 1984 to 2014, if we observe, the 31 times the simultaneous elections were held. Because of these simultaneous elections, at every time a single party has won both the elections, more than 24 times this has happened. And the same statistical correlation will not happen or is not happening when the elections are held separately for Lok Sabha and Legislative Assembly. It means that the simultaneous elections are influencing the voting behavior of the voters. And constitutional feasibility. Now, the confidence, no confidence motion can overthrow the government at the center or the states. And we have federalism where the constitution gives powers to the states and the union simultaneously. So in this scenario, if any government is overthrown due to the no confidence motion, obviously the simultaneous elections agenda will be thrown away. So in these circumstances, the constitutional feasibility will only be possible or will only be available if the constructive motion of no confidence exists. It means, without any alternative, no confidence motion cannot be passed by the opposition. So this is what is need to be amended. Our constitution need to be amended to provide the space for the no confidence, constructive motion of no confidence. And finally, the elections in midterm are like a warning to the government of the day. It sends a notion to the government that what is the popular mood about the functioning of the government, and it helps them for course correction. So these are all will not be possible if the simultaneous elections are being conducted. And coming to the data accumulation by the government. Today, the accumulation of the data, the storage and retrieval of the data through technological advancement is going to cause two major challenges to the people. One is the right to privacy is getting violated, and the second one is the cyber security challenges. Now if you observe, government is maintaining different data sets, and these data sets are expected to be integrated over a period of time. The central monitoring system is already operational in Delhi and Mumbai, which is going to take the control over the voice calls which have been made from these two major cities. And the national integration grid will be operational from the next year. Already Aadhaar has got a joint collection of the data, which will be improved over a period of time. So in this context, India is bound to become a national surveillance state, and the surveillance excesses are bound to inhibit, are bound to violate the privacy rights of the citizens. Added to that, the government is not clear about the security measures taken to protect the databases at these levels. The cyber security challenges still remain. Next one is joining the climate high table. So in this context, we have greenhouse gas emissions. So India has made strong promises before at the Paris conference to reduce its energy intensity by 33 to 35%, and also to achieve 100 gigawatts of the solar power by 2022. So like this, lofty promises are being made. India is ratifying the Paris Agreement by October 2nd, 2016. So in this context, what are the steps India has to take? The first thing, a national consensus have to be developed for green energy initiatives. So a policy directive with involvement of the states have to be developed for, and the taxation of the fossil fuels. And after that, providing for an electricity grid that improvises or that takes into access the energy produced from non-renewable sources, and increasing the efficiency of the transport and buildings in urban areas. All these things have to be quickly taken up. If not, India, once it ratifies the Paris Agreement, the pressure on it is bound to increase. Now, GST Council. Now, 122nd Constitutional Amendment Bill for Goods and Services Tax was passed by the Parliament, and President also gave his assent to it. So, the GST Council has to work out of the various formalities related to the implementation of the Goods and Service Tax. So, the first meeting was held in a cordial atmosphere, and it was decided that the traders and the small companies less than 20 lakhs, they do not come under the GST net. And the second thing is, previously it was suggested that there will be dual supervision, but GST Council made a decision that the companies having the turnover less than 1.5 crore, they come under the assessment of the state. Greater than 1.5 crore, they will come under the assessment of the center. And another thing is, the revenue or else the compensation formula is also broadly decided at the GST Council. So this give and take atmosphere will provide for the country to reach to the deadline of implementation of the GST, that is from 1st April 2017. Now coming to Indus Water Treaty. So India is looking at renegotiation or redrafting of the Indus Water Treaty, but no such a thing has happened in the Prime Ministerial meeting. But India has appointed Interministerial Committee to study the further options India has and its storage possibilities. Indus Water Treaty has come into existence in 1960 with the mediation of the old bank. So according to this, three west flowing rivers, these shall not be interrupted by India, and the water shall get into Pakistan. These are Indus, Jhelum and Chenab. On the other hand, the Ravi, Bias and Sutlej, these eastern rivers, these eastern branches, they come to India. So in these circumstances, 80% of the Indus water, these are benefiting the Pakistan, and this treaty is said to be too generous to Pakistan. And there are repetitive claims from the Pakistan that there is no proper drinking water and other water resources available for it. So in this context, India can use the water on the western rivers for irrigation purposes and also navigation and generation of the electricity. For that, India is building various run-of-the-river dams. What do you mean by the run-of-the-river dams? It means that the water will be made to flow onto the dam, electricity is generated, and the water is pumped back again into the stream. Because of this, the Pakistan will never get affected due to the loss of the water. So, what are the decisions made by the India under the Prime Minister's meeting? The first one is, the water under India's share will be used to fullest. The Indus Water Commission will be suspended till the terror stops. What is this Indus Water Commission? A conflict resolution mechanism was also part of this agreement, where permanent Indus Water Commissions will be constituted on both the sides, and they meet once in a year to discuss the pending issues. If the issue is not solved at these levels, it will be escalated to the World Bank. World Bank will appoint a representative. So this is what is the conflict resolution mechanism we have. So in these circumstances, India has suspended the talks of the Indus Water Commission, and India is planning to build more run-of-the-river water dams for the production of the hydropower. So especially on Pakaldul, Sawalkot and Bursar dams in Jammu and Kashmir will be built onto this. Now, PSLV C-35. So PSLV is the workhorse of the India's ISRO, and it has sent 8 satellites into the orbits. Now, the speciality of this rocket is these are sent into two different orbits. Previously, two different rockets were used to send the satellites into two different orbits. Now, one machine is able to keep the satellites in two different orbits. So, in this case, India's weather satellite, and added to that, the two satellites, that is Pradham and PSAT from Indian Educational Institutions, three from Algeria, ALSAT, Algeria satellite 1A, 1B, 1B, 2B, and 1N, and also US satellite called Pathfinder 1, Canada satellite NLS-19. These are the eight satellites launched from PSLV C-35. Now, because of this launch, the marketability and versatility of the PSLV C-35 will increase. And next, coming to tax notoriety. Try to understand the difference between tax avoidance and tax evasion. So what is meant by the tax avoidance under this? So the legal loopholes are used for non-payment of the taxes. Tax evasion means intentionally the laws are violated to not to pay the taxes. And most of the multinational companies, they take the tax avoidance route by utilizing the tax loopholes. Now, between many countries, double taxation avoidance agreements are there. So that is the reason why the MNCs, whatever the profits generated in one country, these are shown as the profits in the other country which has zero taxation or very low tax. For example, Apple, for all its profits generated across the world, it shows them as the profits in the Ireland. So because of this, it has need not pay any tax over there, because the Ireland and the Apple company, they have a special tax arrangement or special arrangement in which the taxes offered to the Apple are very low, to the extent of 0.05%. As the revenue increases, it is going to the extent of 0.005% of the taxes, which is very low. So in this context, European Commission, so it has issued a notice to the Apple company to pay $15 billion as fine. And it has also suggested the Northern Ireland to revise its tax treaty with the Apple. It is not just the story of the Northern Ireland, the Luxembourg, Netherlands, all these countries to attract the investments they are offering for very low tax rates. So now Apple and Ireland are challenging the European Commission judgment over here. Here, there is something called profit sharing and base erosion. So what is this profit sharing and base erosion means? The wealth created in one country is shifted to the other country to avoid the taxes on the profits. This is what is called base erosion and profit sharing. Now, coming to budgets. The budget is going to be preponed to the February 1st. It means that 1 month, normally it is on the last day of the February, it will be shifted to the first day of the February. Because of this, the entire process will be completed by the end of the March. So as the financial year in India starts from 1st April, the budget will be readily available by the 1st April and the disbursement of the funds to the states will become very easy. Previously, the budget, the entire exercise used to be finished by the May mid or May end. So the parliament used to approve 1/6 of the budget as vote on account budget, and it would be given for the executive disbursement. Now, there is no need for the vote on account budget as the total budget will be discussed and available by the 1st of the April, the start of the financial year. For this, the cabinet has already given its approval. These are the articles for today. Thank you very much.